Has your loved one lost his mind? Do you find yourself asking where his marbles went? Do you find him mumbling to himself or drooling on himself at night? Well, it is possible that your loved one has gone insane.
Crazy for feeling.
How long?
12 hours, you?
About 5 or so. The woman took off?
Like a bullet train.
You try giving it a tug?
Of course.
Powerful stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, Mr. Wankland? Mr. Wankland? We can see you in the back office now.
That's me.
Oh my, that is a terrible case.
Oh. Must have pull my hair. Oh, oh, Lord. Oh, that's my God. Oh, get your finger out. Oh, put it back in.
Oh,
Lord.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Oh, I think you're okay.
Mr. Wankland, I think you're better now.
And you're an extra thief. Come this way.
Hey, baby. Look at that gun, huh? Huh? It's like a fucking bazooka.
At Republican Hospital, our staff is trained to cater to the emotional, physical, and spiritual needs of your precious loved one.
How? Stop sticking me with that thing.
Are you waiting for the train?
Yeah.
You know, I work for the firm downtown. I don't normally have this much time off this time of the year, being tax season and all, with the Schedule 40s and Schedule Cs and those 5828s. Those are something unreal.
Is this your way of trying to hit on me?
Well, I just thought that I'm trying to make a little conversation.
I mean, why didn't you just throw boiling water on me?
Have you filed your taxes yet?
Cash is the best kind of asset you can have. I like cash.
If you want to invest your money, who are you going to call? Ghostbusters? No, you're going to call your happy, horny Wall Street broker. He can sell you all sorts of investments that he can't even explain to himself. Cash is good.
Cash is king. Remember that. Cash is king.
Jim. None of these fellows have any money.
That's not true. Waldo has a stash under his mattress.
Is it true, Waldo?
I like to store cash underneath my bed from time to time. Yeah, I like cash.
You see, he's on it.
Buy stocks! Buy stocks! Because Jim says they always go up. Buy.
Okay, Waldo. You know what? It's nap time. It's time for you to take a nap. Come on, let us go.
I like naps, but never in the afternoon. I have a client coming at 3, so I have to review the code. IRC section 42.6, I must review the code.
Beer goggles for those lonely nights when just about anyone will do.
I won, Billy Mays. I told you I would defeat you, and I did. You were a noble competitor, but in the end, you were outdone by your own eggheadedness. Now, speaking of eggs, have you ever had trouble opening them? Perhaps you should buy my new Hammermatic egg opener. You can use it in the basement. You can use it in the bathroom. You can use it in the kitchen. You can use it on the hood of your car, boat, SUV, or tank, depending on where you happen to be at the moment. Here's how it works. You take this egg, right? And then you smash it with this hammer. It's so simple a mental patient could do it. You getting this, camera guy? Watch as I demonstrate.
Yes. What are you doing? This is my commercial.
I'm demonstrating my new Hammermatic egg opener.
Are you threatening me? Orderly, please, come here. Remove that piece of trash. Now, well.
I've got this mounted triangle. He's gonna feel it. He's gonna know it. He's gonna know who's daddy.
Gorgeous Gary Sebastian, my ass. You should see his cock. It's just not that pretty, okay?
He'll find out the size of my cock when I get his back.
I don't know, he didn't get circumcised when he was a kid or something, but you know, it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna bitch slap you in the fucking ring, boy!
You know what? I got your fucking ass.
Yeah, what are you gonna do with that?
I'm
fuck
gonna
you,
take
man.
Your ass, yeah. And I'm gonna make you my little boy.
Bring it
my
on,
little
man!
Bitch.
Bring it on!
Gay MMA. Sponsored by Vinny's All Natural Anal Lubricant.
And you must admit, he has a lovely smile.
You are not going to get away with this, Hassan.
Explode! Death to Bush!
No, nothing. Nothing.
Yes.
Oh, yeah! What? Oh, yeah! Run the other way, you stupid jerk! Caroline! Caroline!
What the hell do you want?
Get me another beer.
We ain't got none left.
What do you mean we ain't got none left? I done bought a case last night at the Piggly Wiggly.
That's right. And you drank seven last night and I had eight. And then you've been sitting around here on your lazy ass all day screaming at the goddamn football game. So there must be, what, six there on the table? Since you ain't graduated yet. Let me do the math for you. 8 + 7 = 16. Plus your 6, that's 20. And I done drank 5 while I was doing my hair. So how many's that? 7 + 8 + 6 + 5 = 24. Any dumbass could figure that one out. Get your lazy corpse down to the Piggly Wiggly and get us some more. While you're at it, pick me up some of them Little Debbie cakes and some of that there cream from our girly pots.
So, please, tell me about your problem.
I feel so guilty. I killed my business partner.
No, you didn't, you stupid fuck. Doc, I keep hearing him in my ear. He's haunting me.
Well, you didn't kill your partner. He is standing right behind you.
Look, Doc, stop humoring me. I mean, I know he's just in my head. That's why I'm here.
You stupid asshole. The only reason we're here is because you recommended our entire division sign up for the Brown Cross healthcare program. And if we hadn't, we'd get a 5-star mental health retreat with a therapeutic golf course.
Pig fucker! We're here because you got me to burn down the call center and then you died in the fire.
What the fuck are you talking about? I was in Palm Springs with Trixie from Human Resources, giving her the old Hungarian hot pocket.
Wow, a Hungarian hot pocket. My God, where did you get the theme for it?
You mean you can hear him?
Of course I can.
Oh, gee, I didn't know my brand of crazy was so contagious.
Your crazy isn't contagious, but lame-ass incompetence is.
That's it, you stupid fucking poltergeist.
Okay, so the other day I go to the doctor for my annual checkup and I say, Doc, look, it hurts when I do this. And he says, so don't do that.
What do we got here, Pete?
Not good, Chief. Bad first date. Girl called it in. Beer cans on the nightstand and floor, semen stains on the sheets and blankets.
Premature ejaculation?
Oh, no doubt.
What a pig.
It gets worse.
What do you mean?
Skid marks. Look.
Ah, get that away from me. What are you, crazy?
Sting on.
Hey, I'm Ron Scaramy. You all know my work, and the secret of my success is shaft wow.
Ever since I was a little boy, the first thing I knew was I could never be president.
I said, Doc, look, when I drink a cup of coffee, I get a pain in my eye. What should I do? He says, well, take the spoon out of the cup.
Mr. Jones, we're here to make.
What are you doing, Blondie? Give me back my broom. Get out of here. Don't get your tits out of my face. I'm a married man. What are you? Get out of here, you nuts. You people are get.
Oh my God, he's got a gun. Run, run. We're just here trying to help.
The hell you are. Get the fuck out of here. Turn that gun out of my face.
The only way you can have a miracle, a Jew has to be involved. You know, like Jesus walked on the water and Moses parted the sea. If the Jew's not involved, you couldn't call it a miracle. You know, Samson beat the shit out of 1,000 Philistines with the jawbone of an ass. Think any Christian could do that?
These are jokes, people. Look, I don't dance. This is it. You want my teeth? I'll give you my teeth for a laugh. You want that?
Again?
Yeah.
Nah. Too Jewish.
Tomorrow, while you fuckheads are dotting your I's and crossing your T's and kissing the boss's ass, I'll be home smoking a big bowl. I'm out of here, you asswipes. So symbolic, if I knew.